All right. RJ, thanks for being with us today. You know, for those that are still relatively new to your story, they don't know you came to the stock markets with 5,000 rupees back in 1986, how much you had to convince your father that this is what you wanted to do, and the kind of risks you took early in your career before you struck lucky with Tara Tea, I think it was initially. Tell us about your journey, those turning points.
Well, I think the first turning point was at 5,000 rupees. But my brother was a practicing chartered accountant. And he introduced me to some of his clients. And I explained to them, and there's a Christian gentleman who gave me 10 lakhs of rupees. Right? And I used to give him 24% interest at that time. So the first way of getting capital was through the introductions and confidence my brother gave to his clients. And therefore, I could raise about 15 lakhs of rupees, and I made about 40, 50 lakhs of that in 2 years. And then I think the real second turning point was the budget of Mandu Dhanvate. Because there was extreme bearishness in the market. And, the biggest players in the market told me that if he abolishes income tax, the index will go to 400 and 460 and back will go to 300. That was a kind of, and I knew that, VP Singh was the Prime Minister, and he was a man who, abolished estate duty, brought down rates of tax from 90%. So I realized that he will not give a budget which is unfriendly to business. Although he was a Thakur, he understood business. So say in 89, before the budget, my net worth was 2 crores. And I staked it all in the evening, I was worth 20 crores. And, my wife and material never asked me for anything except when we will have air conditioners in the house. So at 2:30 in the night, I went and told her, my wife asked me, kya hua? Main bola, apne AC aa gaye. So, and then it was, I got company of good friends like Mr. Damani, Radhakrishnan Damani, Ramesh Damani, Kamal Kabra. I learned right things in life. We should do the correct things. Read, experience, learn. And then it's been a steady journey. And the quest to learn is a journey. It's not a destination. So I have much learned, but I'm still learning every day.
And I'm going to ask you more about that, because if anything you've said, that experience has taught you, you can continue to learn. And at a time when so many young investors are getting into the market and everything is available to them at just a click of a mouse, do you think perhaps the element of risk has gone up manifold from the time when you were selecting stocks, you were looking for those gems in the market?
Risk is a four-letter word. And it's an adjective. So it means different things to different people, right? But remember one thing, risk, debt, markets, weather, we can all try to predict it, we cannot know it. Only the future will tell us what it is. So what is risk? But I know one thing, that risk is the essence of life. If you don't risk, you are nothing.
Okay.
Right? When I think there are few risk takers like me in life, right? But I'm a very measured risk taker. And in the sense that I can sacrifice my assets and sell them at below par value, but I should never let my financier have his hand over me. My financier, I have to be here, my financier has to be here. The day you put him here, you're risking. On the day of COVID, the index was 7,500, I sold 400 crores worth of shares in 2 days. I wanted 400 crores in the bank. So, leverage has no mother, leverage has no father, leverage has no friends. Leverage is merciless. So, I think when you take a risk, you should be conscious of it. And if things turn against you, you should be able to bear that loss without any damage emotionally or any substantial financial damage. Emotionally affect.
So if I take a look at your portfolio, sir, last 18 months or so, I think estimates suggest that 40,000 crores today is the value of your portfolio, 5.6 billion or so. And you've had some of the biggest successes, even in the worst of times. Titan, Tata Motors, just to name a few.
John Paul Getty had a reign as the longest richest man of the world. They asked him, how much do you have? He said, if you can count it, you don't have it. So, kya kinna? Kisko gina hai? Kisko balance sheet dikhani hai? हमारी एक पार्टनर है, एक क्लाइंट है रेखा जुनून वाला, उसको तो कोई इंटरेस्ट है नहीं, राइट? शी नॉट बॉर्डर, शी इज बिलियनर और शी इज वर्थ 200 मिलियन और 400 मिलियन, बट आई एंश्योर दैट शी डाइवोर्सेस मी, आई डोंट हैव टू पे एनी मनी, राइट? सो आई इट्स कीप काउंट मेक्स नो डिफरेंस रियली. आई लुक एट इट दिस वे दैट इवन इफ आई हैव 10-15% ऑफ द वेल्थ दैट वी हैव टुडे, आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रिंक द सेम विस्की, ड्राइव द सेम कार, ईट द सेम फूड, हैव द सेम हॉलीडे. So beyond the point, it's, if I don't trade and I don't invest, what do I do? Rekha will say, you know, when I don't, suppose I don't go to the office for 5-7 days, pehle to gussa hogi, you have no time, all the time you are working, but 7 days I don't go to the office, she will say, kya baat hai, aajkal aap office nahi jaate hain? Because she is the queen of the house, when I get out, she is the queen and the king. So I really don't count, but I am happy. I do it more. See, we are middle class people. मेरे को तो आदत है, जहाँ भी जाऊँगा राइट हैंड साइड देखूँगा. तो आज मानसिंह में ठहरा हो तो उधर के फिक्स ब्रेकफास्ट इज मच चीपर. वहाँ फ्रूट अलग मंगाओ, अपना सीरियल अलग मंगाओ, ब्रेड अलग. तो मैं उसको पूछा, तेरा फिक्स ब्रेकफास्ट खाए भाई? You're supposed to serve a fixed breakfast.
Your shirt had so much commentary, the one you wore when you went to see the Prime Minister.
I to go to office in my shorts. क्या है उसमें? कोई कस्टमर नहीं है, कोई क्लाइंट नहीं है, अपनों क्या करना है? अपना कस्टमर कैप्टिव है. So I look at things very differently. What it gives me is a sense of achievement and sense of happiness. See, I don't want to, it is, I am, you know, it gives me an ego. I try to predict. What is the market? It's a prediction. I try to predict. And I'm right sometimes, I'm wrong sometimes. When I'm right, I feel very elated. When I'm wrong, I learn. The biggest cost of a mistake is not learning from it. Not afraid to make a mistake. Only one is which I can afford, so that I may live to make another one. If I'm afraid to make a mistake, I won't decide. I can't do anything.
But all these young investors that are watching your rise, and they've seen it over the years, and they see market gurus like yourself, especially after certain stocks that they know you own, are just going from record to record, and you're talking about that also.
Ma'am, yeah. Tips are hazardous for health. Jab lene ko bolo, chillata tha June 2020 mein. It's a chance of a lifetime. Kisne liya kya? 5 saal baad main chillaunga, becho! बोले क्यों बेचे, अभी तो बढ़ने वाला है. सो सी यू कैन नॉट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द स्टॉक मार्केट इज फायर, इट्स आग, इट्स नॉट इजी. ये बाजार से पैसा कमा के ले जाना, इट्स वेरी एक्साइटिंग, बट रिमेंबर इट्स नॉट द रेस कोर्स. एंड वो क्या है कि फर्स्ट थिंग आई टेल पीपल इज, खुद कमा के ट्रेड करो, खुद कमा के इन्वेस्ट करो, ससुर का पैसा और बाप के पैसे से मत करो. And see, what is stock market? I think if I get 18% return on my portfolio, I'm a king. If I get 21%, I'm an emperor. So, boss, either it's not you're going to get 40% return or 80% return. So, aur fir kya hai, people come in seasons. Kya bolte hai, teji mein sabka bolwala, mandi mein sabka muh kala. So, teji mein sab aa jate, mandi mein sab bhag jate. 24 ghante kaun rehta? So you require a far more mature attitude, right? And it's a professional business. And you know, markets and cooking, they can't be taught, they have to be learned. And you see, most successful investors are known after the age of 50-55. Okay. So, and it is not my duty to advise, kyunki koi manta nahi hai. सब क्यों अपन अप्लाई अप्लाई नो रिप्लाई, अपने को क्या लेना देना? अभी लोग बोलते हैं शेयर ले लो. एक दो दोस्त को मैंने बताया ये ले लो वो ले लो. क्यों, क्या है? मैं बोला देयर इज नॉट टू क्वेश्चन व्हाई, देयर इज बट टू डू एंड डाई. सेड लॉर्ड टेनिसन, चार्ज ऑफ द लाइट ब्रिगेड. तो अभी एडवाइस ज्यादा देने का नहीं, आप समझे ना, कोई सुनता नहीं है. सो एंड देन इफ यू गिव देम एडवाइस देयर ओन रीजन, देन दे वोंट अप्लाई देयर ब्रेन. व्हाई यू आस्किंग मी?
So last year, even at the worst of times, You called it. You said it's the beginning of a multi-year bull run, India's biggest bull run. Everyone was so skeptical. Midst of the pandemic, and Rakesh Jhunjhunwala is saying, ki abhi to shuru bhi nahi
hua. There's no reasons. See, it's a flu, it's not a cancer. And humanity has faced greater challenges in life. After the Spanish flu, we had the roaring 20s in America. And remember the word, that crisis and opportunity has the same symbol in Chinese, right? So the question is that you have, you know, it's very popular to do what's popular in markets. See, the human mind has an inertia. It wants to be part of the crowd thinking. But we have to have deeper thoughts. And you also have a risk-reward ratio. You have a company like Tata Motors, whose sale was 3 lakhs, back to the house of Tata's, whose market cap was 25,000 crores. A company whose sale is 3 lakh crores, who is the leader in the truck vehicle markets, who has one of the most successful international, you know, car model, is available for 25,000 crores. 80 rupees value, what is the risk-reward issue? There is this crisis, but when I buy a stock, I always assess the risk-reward ratio. That in my judgment, how much value it can lose and how much value it could gain over time. So crisis opportunity and press se bahut dar lagta hai, but the role the press has played in frightening the Indian public. You know, my daughter comes to me and asks me, Daddy, is there any site, any newspaper, any magazine which I can read so that I'm not depressed? So the kind of feedback, and then it all spreads. Third wave kab aa rahi hai bhai sahab? Aa rahi hai kya third wave? Puri sahab, third wave aa rahi hai kya?
Third wave. Achha, third wave ka to pata nahi market crash aa raha hai ki nahi aa raha.
Well, you know, markets are like women, always commanding, always mystery. But always commanding, always mysterious, always uncertain, always volatile, always exciting. So we can't really know. But see, index has gone from 7,500 to 18,000. And we have had a lot of correction, but there was circular correction. In the sense, one group of shares were going up, one group of shares were correcting. So I think, a correction can happen. We could be 7,500 ka 20,000 ki 18,000 ho jaye, I don't know, overrule. But I see no reversal. And this sideways correction, where a group of stocks correct, other group of stocks go up. That could continue. So stocks have corrected, but the index as a whole has not corrected.
Okay.
So I am very bullish, and I think abhi to 4 crore demat, people are saying, 4 crore demat accounts have been opened, retail public is participating. अरे 90 करोड़ मेल्स हैं, 90 करोड़ जनरल्स हैं इंडिया में, वो 80 करोड़ तो अभी आने हैं डीमैट अकाउंट्स. सो आई फील वेरी बुलिश. करेक्शंस विल ऑलवेज कम एंड आई कैन नॉट टाइम द मार्केट बियॉन्ड द पॉइंट.
बट सर, इन द पास्ट इट्स ऑलवेज बीन द रिटेल इन्वेस्टर, द यंग इन्वेस्टर दैट्स सफर्ड द मोस्ट, इट्स बीन बर्नड द मोस्ट. इफ वी टेक अ लुक एट द लेटेस्ट फिगर्स ऑल्सो, डोमेस्टिक buying is what's driving the market right now.
But what happens, the domestic investor first gains. क्या होता है, कोई आया नहीं, वो 1,000 लगाता है, उसको 2,000 आता है, फिर वो 2,000 लगा देता है, फिर उसको 6,000 आता है, फिर वो क्या करता है, वो 6,000 और 10,000 16,000 लगा देता है. Then he starts believing anything, he starts buying at any price. तो वो सब अभी cycle में बहुत time होता
है. So how does someone know when to sell?
Pardon?
How does somebody know when to sell? Given the markets are at record highs.
I sell for 3 reasons. One, I feel that the earnings have peaked and the PE has peaked, because price is equal to EPS multiplied by PE. Or if I feel that I can get a better investment. Otherwise, I don't sell generally.
You've always said if it's overvalued, it'll continue to be overvalued at some point.
Titan
it can only get better. So,
Titan
yeah.
is overvalued from the price of 300. The price is 2400 today.
Okay. So if I were to buy, or if an investor was looking to buy, what are you most bullish on right now? Where it's also fair value.
That advice I reserve for my wife and my sisters and girlfriend. I don't give that advice.
Theme bata do. You're bullish on the India story.
Yeah, so
consumer, real estate.
So I'm bullish on everything. And it's a buffet. Eat what you want, don't eat too much.
But where's the value fair? Look at the markets these days.
Ma'am, value is perception. Value is an adjective. Right? It's not, what is value? Is there anybody in the world who can say a stock is good at 12 times earning and not good at 20 times earning? You must say it's not good at 12, I'll say it's good at 20. So how do you discover the value? This value is discovered by market pricing. And remember one thing. The stock market will always make excesses. Your opportunity lies in recognizing that excess. Okay. And finally, value will come to mean. And valuations will be finally based on cash flows. Ye share bazaar hai. Mehak nahi aa sakti kagaj ke phoolon se. Right? So don't be surprised. Iska itna value ho gaya. Zomato ka 1,40,000 ho gaya. But milenge 5 saal baad. Dekhenge. Abhi nahi bechne ka. Chaddi nikal jayegi. Samay aayega. So the excesses market will correct itself. And excesses have to, no, it will take place. It will correct. It requires time. You need to take 1800 ka bhav ka kya bhav hai abhi? 6 rupaya. You need to take top mein kitna hua tha? I don't mean to single out any management. Himachal kya hua tha? Global kya hua tha? And whole Delhi, whole India, Calcutta, Bombay, Himachal, bhai global, bhai United. So, sab samay ki baat hai. Pani, dood. Aur abhi aap bologe ki Zomato mat lo, gadha hai, tere ko akal nahi hai. Main 1500 mein bolta tha, Unitech mat lo, to gadha bolta tha. To abhi kyon bolne ka, dekhne ka, maja.
But RJ, there is a unicorn every day. How does one ignore that entire segment of the new economy?
Well, there are, ma'am, people say, why don't you buy crypto? I don't go. Have to go to every party in town. You think crypto can last? You think anybody, I and my wife are going for a restaurant for dinner at 100 rupees with 100 rupee budget. And you want to go and know that it's 80 rupees value. We have ordered and bill like, and 20% gaya crypto. Ka. So what will you do? Ya to bole biwi ka bangal rakh de. Which sovereign state is going to give the right to issue a currency to anybody ass? Yeah, it's a fact. One of the biggest power of a nation is the issue of currency. So I think crypto is worse than the Malashmi race course. Then second thing is, this is not the first time in history that all these unicorns are born. What happened during the railroad boom? What happened during the internet boom? How many have survived? Right? What happened during the tulip boom? So all this, what happened during the Californian gold boom? Everything is going to return to mean. And final valuation is cash flow. So that is history. That's not my opinion. I only want to accept it. Because see, valuations and markets are driven by human psychology. Right, and that psychology has not changed and will not change in history. Greed and fear. Yep. So ma'am, good luck, but I respect the internet promoters for their dedication, their hard work. I mean, I wish I could have the energy. So I don't want to be critical of any company, but ma'am, valuation is a most important consideration.
Aviation. You are big on aviation. You're entering the sector. We've got Aditya here in the crowd as well. You know, at a time when companies have gone bust, they're still battling with figuring out the right business dynamic. Why are you so big on aviation?
They have made me sign a legal agreement. That I cannot talk about the airline unless it starts. But one thing I can tell you, that when I came to the stock market from a conservative Marwari Agarwal family as a chartered accountant, my mother said, who will marry you? So I told my mother, you will have one less daughter-in-law to trouble you. Right? So now, I am going to the airlines. I came with 1,000 rupees in the market. Everybody said, pair chhuega. Naam kharaab kar dega baap ka, paisa nahi dega gaon ka. I proved them wrong by God's grace and the blessing of my elders. ठीक है, हमने भी लगाई है एयरलाइन में, देखेंगे क्या होता है. और देख क्या मैंने क्यों लगाया है, नहीं लगाया है, सक्सेसफुल हुआ तो बताऊंगा, फेलियर हो गया तो बोलूंगा मुझे कुछ मालूम नहीं था, वाज़ रॉन्ग, बट आई एम प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर फेलियर.
फेलियर हो गया तो यू नो,
आई एम टेकिंग अ कॉन्शियस रिस्क. लेट मी टेल यू, आई एम कॉन्शियस ऑफ द रिस्क आई एम टेकिंग, राइट, एंड आई एम कॉन्शियस ऑफ व्हाट द रिटर्न्स आई कैन गुड पॉसिबली. सो आफ्टर लाइफ इज अ रिस्क रिवॉर्ड रेशियो, एंड आई गॉट द बेस्ट मैनेजमेंट टीम पॉसिबली. माई टीम हैज ओन्स 40%. एवरी सीनियर एम्प्लॉयज गॉट अ स्टेक. और क्या, हम बाबू लोग नहीं है, हम लोग भी शेयर बाजार नोट छापते हैं, मिडिल क्लास पीपल एसेंशियली. सो ह्यूमन इंटरेक्शन विद द टीम इज फार ग्रेट एंड मोर ह्यूमन देन इन एनी अदर एटमोसफियर. सो आई एम आई शुड नॉट से आई एम 90% होपफुल और ओपिनियटेड दैट वी विल मेक अ सक्सेसफुल एयरलाइन. इट मे टेक लिटिल टाइम.
Divestment, lots of hiccups in the past. Air India is a big one now and seems to be on track. We're waiting for formal notification, but if Tata's take over, that's also going to be big in aviation. But divestment, if they're on track with that, what does it mean for the markets?
No, I think they will be on track this time. I think BPCL, LIC, Container Corporation, Shipping Corporation, I think there will be at least 8 to 10 strategic disinvestments between now and 31st March 2022, including LIC. LIC not strategic. I think the government is very serious on it. And there's a lot of interest from bidders.
There's a lot of talk once you met the Prime Minister. Those pictures went viral. Why is a stockbroker meeting the Prime Minister? Why?
First of all, ma'am, let me tell you one thing. Hmm. I pay at least $1.5 million of brokerage a year. I am not a broker. I pay $1.5 million of brokerage a year myself. Mm-hmm. Right? So I'm not a broker. Sorry, I had to correct you.
Yes. Yeah.
Right? And why the Prime Minister met me, you ask him.
Okay.
I don't know why he met me. Right?
So, wanted to also get a sense, there were some comments that were circulating about something that you said many years ago, saying that democracy in India is the biggest hindrance to growth.
I would have never said those words. Hmm. I say that the two things needed for, if you examine history, the societies which have achieved and sustained prosperity in life have two qualities, skills and democracy.
Right.
That's what I've always said in life. And democracy, because it allows, democracy creates chaos. Mm. It gives people the power to think. It gives the power people to act. It thinks of people, the brain develops. If somebody gave me $20 million, I will not educate my children in Singapore. Because I want them to question why. Mm. The tennis courts and the swimming pools are not important. The development of my child's brain is important. He has to be rebellious from day one. Mm. That is democracy. And skills. So I think we have a deep rooted in democracy from 1989 to 2014, 22 years we had coalitions, right? And let me tell you one thing, there is a Right of Information Act. We were deep rooted, and I must compliment the press that we have. I may not agree with them on many things, but we have a free press. So I have never said this. I think democracy is most needed. Hmm. And see what happens, कि जब आदमी भूखा नंगा है, खाने का नहीं है ना, तो उसको डेमोक्रेसी और डिक्टेटरशिप का फर्क नहीं है. पर आप तू देखना चाइना में क्या होता है 5 साल में, जब पेट बैठ जाता है, मीट खाता है, $15,000 पर कैपिटल हो जाएगा, he want freedom. We don't know what kind of social unrest will take place in China. And one of the reasons I think they don't let growth go down is because they don't want social unrest. They realize the moment growth goes down, there'll be social unrest. So skills and democracy. Look at Korea, look at Taiwan. Yeah. They were dictatorships until they achieved prosperity. But to sustain it. So that's why, India has got the inherent assets. I mean, we were 35% of world GDP in 1640. And when the British left, we are 2%, today we are 7%. So I'm bullish, and I'm bullish in the stock market. You know, in 2008, corporate profit to GDP was 8%. In 2019-20, they were 3%. So America is 11% corporate profit to GDP.
So we're at 60,000 now. Targets? You feel India is going to catch up to China next 15 years, you said.
कि मैं ज़रा चार पाँच छः पैकवी के लेट जाता हूँ तो मालूम है रेखा गुस्सा होने वाली है कितना गुस्सा होने वाली क्या मालूम तो वी कैन नो द डायरेक्शन वी कांट नो द क्वांटम
कुछ तो बता दो लाइक नेक्स्ट कपल ऑफ इयर्स नेक्स्ट ईयर
सी द सेंसेक्स इज गोइंग टू बी 5 लाख वन डे बट आई डोंट नो द डे हाउ मेनी इयर्स बट आई एम इमीडिएटली बुलिश आई थिंक वी आर कमिंग इनटू अ फेज व्हिच इंडिया इकोनॉमिकली हैज नेवर सीन And we have created, we are living in a country with $1 trillion of savings. And it is so good, here I feel bullish on land. So land jaunga, idhar jaunga, Sunday jaunga, Monday jaunga, jameen dekhunga, 7-12 dekhunga. Isse acha seedha ya bullish, buy yaar, DLF, 120 nahi aata, buy isme. So the facility and the opportunity that market is giving you, Why will people not invest?
Okay.
So I am very bullish and there's so much of savings to come. Today 31% of household wealth in America is equity. In India it's 3%.
So you're saying that India's time has come, that this is different from all the previous bull runs because
Main
of the...
bol raha hun, yeah. Hamara time aayega. Nahi, hamara time aa gaya hai. Hamara time aayega, se hamara time aa gaya hai, alag hai. अब आ गया है वो बोलता है ना कि मुहूर्त का समय आ गया हिंदी फिल्म में कन्या को लाइए तो हिंदुस्तान का मुहूर्त हो गया है यू नो व्हाट ट्वेन हैज सेड नो व्हाट गॉड ऑर्डेंस इवन टाइम कैन नॉट डिस्टेन व्हाट टाइम ऑर्डेंस इवन गॉड्स कैन नॉट डिस्टेन तो इट इज माय पर्सनल ओपिनियन आई डिजर्व द राइट टू बी रॉन्ग कि पीपल विल बी सरप्राइज्ड एट द अपसाइड्स इन द इंडियन And we have created the infrastructure for mopping savings in a country with $1 trillion of savings, projected to go to $3 trillion by 2030. You mean $3 trillion of savings? Kahan lagayenge? And every year, the financial part of savings is increasing. Their savings 100 rupees hoti hai. The financial saving was say 25, which is fixed deposit, debt and equity. Now that is going to 30%, 40%, 45%. So it is, अबे तो बहु बहु फाइन छे बहु मजा आ रहा
है। All right. On that note, a big hand, everyone. Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, all the way from Bombay.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, please.
Two questions. Okay, go ahead. Can we? Is there a mic? Yeah.
Well, I have all the time in the world. If the next session is getting postponed. Yeah. Tell you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Words of wisdom as well as lot of entertainment. So, बहुत अच्छा लगा आपको सुन करके.
अरे मैं कोई जोकर तो नहीं हूँ एंटरटेन करने वाला.
No, no.
I'm not Mahmood.
No, no, no. What I meant is that you really lighten up the mood, sir. Two things I want to ask. One thing that SIP.
Please keep the mic
on. Yeah. Two things. One is that SIP. That is for the long term, like 10 years, 20 years. What do you think about it? Because the rate is really high.
I think that's the ideal way for a investor, for a non-professional investor to invest. See, what happens, India is on a growth path. And when you invest in a SIP, you invest in a down market, you invest in an up market. I think SIP is the best way to invest.
Mm-hmm. And one more thing, what is the relationship between the economy and the markets like GDP, inflation, etc. with the Sensex? Because I think that these two things are living in two different planets.
No, I disagree because what happens, markets are anticipating animals, right? Jab actual GDP 10% ho jayenge, toh market nahin badhne wala hai.
Okay.
So markets are anticipating animals. So they predict and I'm telling you, they prove very right, the Dow has done it. We'll read the history of the Dow. It has predicted every recession in America. Right?
Shukriya, shukriya.
Mr. Jhunjhunwala, thank you for a fabulous session.
Closer,
really enjoyed listening to you. You touched upon it. but we'd like to draw you out a little further on your trip to Delhi. It's a rare sight, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala in Delhi. You had a high-profile meeting with the finance minister, with the prime minister. Why he invited you, we'll leave on the side. What did you tell the prime minister and what did he tell you?
भाई स्वागत में मेरी बीवी से क्या बात की तुझे बताने वालों एंड इट्स अ हाई प्रोफाइल मीटिंग बिकॉज सी दे ट्वीटेड इट आई हैड नो फोटोग्राफ बिकॉज आई एम नॉट अलाउड टू टेक माय मोबाइल देयर इज नो अदर वे आई कैन टेक अ फोटोग्राफ सो आई हैव नॉट आई मीन दे ट्वीटेड इट एंड आई टोल्ड द प्राइम मिनिस्टर व्हाट आई थॉट आई एम अ बीजेपी सपोर्टर आई एम अ मोदी सपोर्टर एंड आई थिंक the economy is going to take off. So I made a presentation to him on why I think so and why I support him.
All right. Thank you so much, RJ.